In this video, we'll compare Redis with Valkyrie, which is open source fork of Redis. In the first test, I'll use a virtual machine with a single CPU and run both Redis and Valkyrie in a single threaded mode. We'll measure latency for set and get operations, as well as the maximum throughput each database can handle. We'll also measure CPU usage, memory usage, and network performance. The biggest difference between the two will likely appear in the second test, as they implemented multi-threading independently after the fork. We'll run the same test, but this time using a virtual machine with 4 CPUs and configuring each database to use 4 threads. Initially, I wanted to include KDB as well, but it seems that after the core developer left the company, KDB is no longer supported, and he suggested that development efforts should shift to Valkyrie. As you can see, I used M7A medium instances for both Redis and Valkyrie, and EKS cluster to run my monitoring components and clients to generate load. If you need help with AWS, GCP, Kubernetes, Terraform, or setting up a centralized monitoring system based on Prometheus and Thanos, let me know. Let's go ahead and run the test. I ran this test multiple times on different VMs to ensure there were no noisy neighbors or infrastructure-related issues. The entire test took around 1.5 hours, and I'll compress it into just a few minutes. I'll run this test for 1 more minute, and we'll go over each graph one by one at the end. First, we have throughput. Redis reached around 100,000 requests per second for both set and get operations. Valkyrie, on the other hand, was slightly more stable and reached 107,000 requests per second. Next, we have latency, measured from the client side using P90 percentile. Surprisingly, Valkyrie performed much better in this case. I'm using official Go Redis client, and you can find the source code in my public GitHub repository for this test. Next, we have latency for get operations, showing a similar pattern. As I mentioned, I rerun this test multiple times on different VMs, and each time I got the same latency pattern. You can reproduce it as well. Instructions are in the README file. Next, we have CPU usage, which is more or less the same for both Redis and Valkyrie, except for some spikes in the middle. Then we have memory usage, followed by the network usage for both databases. At this point, you might start to think that Valkyrie is the better option, especially since it's open source and likely to attract more contributors than Redis. But wait for the next test, which convinced me to switch to Valkyrie. In this test, I'm using M7A extra large instances with 4 CPUs each. Here are the very simple configuration files. For this test, I configured both Redis and Valkyrie to use 4 I/O threads. This doesn't mean each database creates only 4 threads. It means 4 threads are used specifically for I/O operations. This test took around 2 to 3 hours to run, so I'll run it again for a minute or so, and then we'll go over each graph at the end. First, we have throughput. Redis reached only 250,000 requests per second, which is better than its single-threaded version, but not close to Valkyrie. Valkyrie achieved 350,000 requests per second in this test. This performance gap convinced me to switch from Redis to Valkyrie. Finally, we can start using larger instances for Redis-like databases, which is easier to manage than having hundreds of small VMs scattered around, each with monitoring exporters that consumes significant resources. Next, we have latency. Lower latency is better, and you can clearly see the difference between the two. Not only does Valkyrie deliver higher throughput, but its overall performance is also better than Redis. The same pattern applies to get latency. Then we have CPU usage. I used the same configuration with 4 threads for each database, and Valkyrie utilizes resources much more efficiently than Redis. Next, we have memory usage. Finally, we have network usage. In my opinion, unless you specifically need new Redis 8.0 features like JSON support or time series databases, there is no reason not to switch to Valkyrie. It performs better overall, is open source, and has a larger community of contributors than Redis. I'll be personally switching to Valkyrie as well.